confident. Nobody run faster than you. Nobody jump higher than you. Nobody's rhythm is better than you. Without us, America is plain mayonnaise. We are the salt.
Right.
We are the pepper. We are the spice.
Right.
We made jazz. We made the stoplight. We made all of this. And now we oppress. And the scriptures tell us to do this. Read.
Isaiah chapter 58 and verse 1.
Read.
Cry aloud.
Come on.
Spare now.
Come on.
Lift up thy voice like a trumpet.
He says, lift up thy voice like a trumpet. So should I not do it? Should I not do it because it's offensive to you? It's offensive to the oppressor?
Give me Galatians 4 and 16.
Should I not do it?
Hold that.
Should I not do that? Should I not cry? The Bible says, cry out loud and spare not. And show your people their transgressions. Your transgressions is you sinning against the Bible.
Behind the bench.
You sinning against the scriptures. And now because we come out and we cry out loud and we spare not. We are the ones that Kanye West is watching. Salakia, Ye is watching. We are the ones that Kyrie Irving is watching. Matter of fact, we're the ones that the whole earth is watching.
Right.
We are the ones. And now because I come out and I cry out loud, I spare not your feelings. And I show my people their transgressions. Guess what? Now, this is what they say about me. Read, where you at, warrior?
Galatians chapter 4.
Where you at?
Galatians chapter 4 verse 16.
Now understand, this is the New Testament. This is the New Testament, right? Listen to what the scriptures have to say. Read.
Am I therefore become your enemy?
Am I what?
Am I therefore become your enemy?
Have I become your enemy? Because the Bible tells me to come and cry out loud and spare not and show thy people their transgression. So now I'm wrong. And now I have come. Read it again.
Am I therefore become your enemy?
No, your friend.
Your enemy?
No, your pastor.
Enemy?
No, your cousin.
Enemy?
No, your kinsman.
Enemy?
I have become your what?
Enemy.
Why?
Because I tell the truth?
Because I tell the truth. Go back to Isaiah 58. Because I tell the truth? Because I do this right here? Read. Listen, when we come out here on these corners, we coming out here on these corners, right? To wake our people up, to give them understanding, to show them their transgressions, to show you that you have been lied to. You are one of the greatest people on the planet.
Right.
You are one of the 12 tribes of Israel.
Right.
You're not black. You're not a nigger. You're not a crayon. You're not an African American. America is named after a man by the name of Amerigo Vespucius. And Africa has been taken by a man, and he's taken on a name, African Scipionis, something like that, Salakia. Scipio Africanus. Scipio Africanus is named after a white man. So now you're African American, you're named after two white men. That's your ethnicity. Salakia. Reverend Jesse Jackson gave us that title in 1984. So if you was born before 1984 and you calling yourself an African American, what was you before that? You was color, black, slave, you was whatever they say, and you hate me because I tell you the truth, because I do this. Read it again.
Isaiah chapter 58 and verse 1.
Read.
Cry aloud.
What?
Cry aloud.
Come on.
Spare not.
Read.
Lift up thy voice like a trumpet.
Come on.
And show my people their transgressions.
And show thy people thy transgressions. That's my job. My job is to show you your transgression. All right? That's my job.
Hey, give me that book, Lost in Tribes.
That's my job. I'm only doing my job. I have been sent by the commanding general Yohana, by the order of who you call today, ignorantly called Jesus Christ. His name is Yahawashah Mashiach. He was a black man. He looked just like me. His mother looked just like your little sister. A little black girl, so-called black girl. Just think about it. If we were to receive the image of Yahawashah and he looked like me, you would respect me more. You will respect the words that come out of my mouth. But you don't respect anything about me. Because of what I look like because of the image of what America has portrayed me to be. When I walk, listen, check this out. When I get up in the morning and I iron my pads, you know what the so-called black man is saying? Will these be the pants and the jeans that they bury me in? Will I be shot dead walking down the street because of the color of my skin? And now you're saying I'm supposed to accept that? Well, what we're going to do is, I'm going to give you an eyewitness if we are the Israelites. I want to see if they'll go down there in Philly and tear down William Penn statue.
Right.
Because according to the so-called Jewish people, they say that this is anti-Semitic. But I'm going to show you an eyewitness report right here in this book. We didn't write this book. We didn't write it. In this book, we have a letter from William Penn. Open him up. We got a letter from William Penn. And William Penn is going to tell you without a doubt the black people in this country is the Israelites. Now, what you going to say about that? They going to go and rip William Penn statue down? Let's go out. Where you at? Right.
Salaki. Right there.
Read. First of all, tell them the name of the book that you got in Arthur. Read.
The book I'm reading from is The 10 Tribes of Israel.
The what?
The 10 Tribes of Israel.
Come on.
By Timothy R. Jenkins.
All right, so now we're going to read out of a book, a copy, an insert of William Penn. Y'all know what William Penn is. They got the clothespin right down 15th and Chestnut. Here's a letter from William Penn. William Penn is going to tell y'all that we're the Israelites. Read.
This is starting from page two. The following is from J.J. Monberg's History of Lancaster County.
This is Lancaster County. What page?
Where's the
Page 68.
Page what?
Page 68. Come on. Being an extract from a letter written by William Penn.
Where is it from?
Written by William Penn.
Who is it from?
By William Penn.
This is from William Penn.
Get it.
This is from William Penn. This is an eyewitness. Listen, that means an eyewitness report is a first-hand report. They use these type of reports in something they call peer review studies. All right, I got it. In peer review studies. Now, listen to what William Penn got to say.
Read. He states of the origin of North American Indian.
Now listen, he's telling you the state of the North American Indians. This is William Penn. Y'all read about William Penn. William Penn is about to tell y'all that we're the Israelites. William Penn is about to do something right now that they say that Kanye West and Kyrie Irving is committing anti-Semitism.
Right.
Y'all need to be going down there and tearing down William Penn statue.
Read. He states of the origin of the North American Indian.
Come on.
I am ready to believe them of the Jewish race.
What? He ready to do what?
I am ready to believe them of the Jewish race.
He said he's ready to believe that they are the Jewish race. All right? That's what he said. So William Penn is saying it. This is William Penn. I want y'all to go down there and tear down his statue right now. Go tear it down. Read what William Penn had to say. Read it out loud. Read.
I am ready to believe them of the Jewish race.
What?
I am ready to believe them of the Jewish race.
Now, this is William Penn. Take it from the top and read it again so they can hear it. Read.
I am ready to believe them of the Jewish race.
Who letter you read?
A letter written by William Penn.
Who is this letter written by?
By William Penn.
Now remember, William Penn has a statue in Philadelphia. I want you to take it from the top. Listen to what he said. He's going to talk about the Northern American Indians. Read.
The following is from J.J. Monberg's History of Lancaster County, Pennsylvania.
Come on.
Page 66.
What page? 68. Page 68. Read.
Being an exact letter written by William Penn.
Who was it written by?
William Penn.
This letter was written by who?
William Penn.
This letter was written by William Penn. Read.
To the Committee of the Free Society of Traders.
Come on.
In London, England.
In London, England.
1683.
In 1683. Read.
He states of the origin of the North American Indians.
Hold it. He's going to tell you, based on his eyewitness report, who the North American Indians are.
Read. I am ready to believe them of the Jewish race.
Of the who?
Of the Jewish race.
No, of the Negro race.
Of the Jewish race.
Of the black race.
Of the Jewish race.
Of the American race.
Of the Jewish race.
Of the what?
Of the Jewish race.
This is what Kyrie Irving said. So now he gotta be, exiled. He gotta be exiled now. That's what we got going on. Look, I'm gonna give you another eyewitness. That's one. Christians say that takes two or more to build truth. You need two or more, right? Watch this. Go down there.
Read Reverend James St. McMillan.
What year is this?
May 13th, 1853.
Read.
To a friend of Allegheny, PA.
Where's he writing from?
Hat writes from Airground, New York.
Where he's writing from New York. In what?
May 13th, 1853.
So now here's another eyewitness. And he's looking at these people. What do he got to say?
Having in my possession a very curious relic.
He found something when he came over here. He found a relic. He's like, what is this? It's very interesting. Now remember, Kanye West is being reported as an anti-Semitism because of this. I just showed y'all William Penn said, we are the Israelites. Now watch what another so-called white man got to say from 1853. From New York.
Read, having in my possession a very curious relic, or facsimile of a relic, of the ancient nation of the Jews.
Of the who?
Of the Jews.
Of the who?
Of the Jews.
No, the Negroes.
Of the Jews.
Of black people.
Of the Jews.
Of African American.
The Jews.
Of American origines.
The Jews.
Of the who?
The Jews.
That's two witnesses right there. They need to go and they need to tear William Penn letter down. They need to tear his letter down. They need to tear his statue down. They need to get rid of that clothespin. They need to get rid of all of it. All of it. Because according to William Penn, we're the Israelites.
Right.
Now a lot of people want to say we Africans. We're not African. We far from it. Far from it. Read the cover of this book and let them know what you read.
I read The Black Image in the White Mind, written by George M. Fredrickson.
What year?
The year of 1817 through 1914.
Now I want you to do me a favor. I want you to turn that book over. And I want you to read right there what kind of book is this?
American history book.
What is it?
American history book.
Now this is an American history book. This is an American history book, right? And in this book, they studied us for over 100 years. Because remember, according to William Penn, and other colonizers, these people are the Israelites, right? So let's see, after they studied us scientifically, what do they have to say? Let's go.
As I would. We get a flyer.
Page 74. In the 1840s.
In the where?
In the 1840s.
This is 1840. This is before William Penn wrote his letter. Right? Me?
In the 1840s, Morton collaborated with George R. Glidden in the Egyptologist who provided him with the mummy heads and the information about racial significance.
Okay, so what you have here, you have someone in Egypt studying the bones and the skulls of the Egyptians. And you got us over here, they're studying our bones and studying our cranium, right?
The racial significance of Egyptian tomb inscription.
So they want to know the racial. They want to know what nation is the Egyptians and what nation is the people over here. And are we the same people? They're trying to see if we're the same people. Read.
In Cranium, published in 1844.
Come on.
Morton pointed out that both cranial and archaeological evidence.
So he's saying both cranial, meaning the head, and the relics, the archaeology finding. Based on that, that's what he's using, read.
Archaeological evidence showed that Egyptians were not Negroes.
Was not what?
Egyptians were not Negroes.
Say it again.
Egyptians were not Negroes.
So he's saying that the Africans, which are Egyptians, are not Negroes.
Right.
Read.
As abolitionists and colonizationists had maintained, and in that fact, blacks have been relegated to the same servile position in the ancient Egyptian as in the modern America.
All right, so what he just said, that's good, that's the why.
Go, get back to the Bible.
So what he said, before y'all leave though, I want to show you something. Go to 1 Kings 8:47. I want to show y'all this, right? Now, what he just read was, is that we as Negroes and the Egyptians, which is Africans, are two different people. But I'm about to show y'all that the Bible can only be written to you. I'm going to show you that the Bible can only be written to you. I'm going to show y'all that the Bible can only be written to you. I'm going to ask you a question. Where you at, I?
1 Kings chapter 8 and verse 47.
Come on.
Yet if thou shalt bethink themselves.
Now, when he says bethink, it means to rethink. Read it again.
Yet if they shall bethink themselves.
So he says if they shall bethink themselves. Bethink means to be born again. All right?
Well, it should be wrapped up.
Yet if they shall bethink themselves in the land whether they were carried captives.
So he says they have to rethink themselves in the land where?
That they were carried captive.
Where they were carried where?
Captive.
Who was carried captive? We were.
I read it.
Was the so-called white man carried captive?
That's why I'm over it.
Was the Africans carried captive? We are the only ones that was carried captive. I'm going to show y'all that it is impossible for the so-called white man to be a part of this book. Watch this. Read.
And repent and make supplication.
Take it from the top.
God on kind. 1 Kings chapter 8 and verse 47.
Come on.
Yet if they shall bethink themselves in the land within they were carried captive.
So he said you got to rethink yourself in the land where you were carried captive.
Read. And repent.
And what?
And repent.
And what?
And repent.
That means that you have to be carried away captive to repent.
Read. And make supplication.
Come on.
Unto the land of them that carried captive.
Now listen to what he said. We got to repent in the land where we were carried captive. How could anybody else fit that? It make you think, don't it?
I know. I read about it. That's why I'm over here.
Most High in Christ. Read that again.
Got on kind. 1 Kings chapter 8 and verse 47.
Come on.
Yet if they shall bethink themselves.
Come on.
In the land where they were carried captive.
Come on.
And repent.
Come on.
And make supplication unto thee in the land of them that they carried captive.
So they're saying that whoever this is, these are a group of people that was carried away captive.
Right.
And they got to repent in the land where they was carried away captive too. This can't be nobody but you. Read.
Saying, we have sinned. Have done perversely. We have committed wickedness.
Come on.
And so return unto thee.
Now watch this. I'm going to show you again. This can only be to you. Read.
And so return unto thee with all their heart and with all their soul in the land of
and
their...
And where?
In the land of their enemies.
Come on.
Which led them away captive.
Which what?
Which led them away captive.
This can only be talking about you. Just like with Moses... When Moses went into Egypt, he didn't say, let whoever go, whoever believe. He said, let my people go. Christ, which is Yahweh Shah, which is your king, he's coming back. And he's going to say, let my people go. And when he say, let his people go, oh boy, I'm going to show you what it's about to be. You got any more on that?
Okay.
Read.
And pray unto thee, and pray unto thee toward their land.
So you gotta be in the land where you were carried away captive and pray to the land where they took you from, where you originally from. Read.
Which thou gave us unto their fathers, the city which thou hast chosen, and the house which I have built for thy name.
You are Israelite. Your land is Jerusalem. It is the Middle East, what they call it today. That's what it is, what I tell you to get. What you got? All right, now. That can only be pertaining to you because you was carried away captive. And I'm going to show you what's going to happen when Yahweh shall return. Give me Revelation 2 and 25. This is the Bible.
I know what it is.
No, not you, Slocky. I'm just saying out loud. This is the Bible. These are the Holy Scriptures. This is the book that you have at home. This is the book that you have in your foyer. You need to read it.
But they just got it sitting there.
They just got it sitting there. Chapter 2. Revelation 2:25. Read.
Revelation chapter 2 and verse 25.
Come on.
but that which ye have already
start at 26.
Kamakai. Revelation chapter 2 and verse 26.
Come on.
And he that overcometh.
If he what?
And he that overcometh.
You know who's those that overcometh? Those are the ones that repent in the land where they were carried away captive and make supplication unto him. All right? And repent for your transgressions. This is for them. Read it again. Tell them where you at.
Revelation chapter 2 and verse 26.
Read.
And he that overcometh.
Come on.
And keepeth my works unto the end. To him I will give power to all. I will give power over the nations.
He will give power to who?
Over the nations.
No, over a nation.
Over the nation.
Over half a nation.
Over the nations.
Over the nations. See, you're going to receive power over the nations. That's what they fear. That's why they go so hard on Kanye. That's why they go hard on Kyrie. They're afraid that if you wake up, you will surpass them. Look, they're basically saying, if they make you equal with them, you're so great that if you become equal, you'll greatly surpass them. Look, they got you way down here, you still surpass them. Imagine if you equal. Imagine if you equal with them. Read it again.
Revelation chapter 2 and verse 26.
Come on.
And he that overcometh and keepeth my works unto the end, to him I will give power over the nation.
Come on.
Verse 27. And he shall rule them with a rod of iron.
We're going to rule you with a rod of what?
With a rod of iron.
Now give me Revelation 2 and 9. Let's see if the Bible is anti-Semitic. Because you got to say the Bible is anti-Semitic. Watch this. Read.
Revelation chapter 2 and verse 9.
He's wrong.
Chapter 2 and verse 9.
Come on.
I know thy works.
I know thy works. Come on.
A tribulation. Come on. And poverty.
Come on.
But thou art rich.
We are blacks, Hispanics, and Native American are rich. Read.
And I know the blasphemy of them that are the Jews.
He know the blasphemy of them that say they are Jews. Give me 3 and 9. Is the Bible anti-Semitic? Because it's definitely coming at them. Read out. Where you at?
Revelation chapter 3 and verse 9.
Where you at?
Revelation chapter 3 and verse 9.
This is your holy Bible. This is the book of Revelation. Read.
Behold, I will make them of the synagogue of Satan.
He said, I will make them the synagogue of Satan. You got to say the Bible is anti-Semitic.
Right.
You got to say it. Read it again.
Revelation chapter 3 and verse 9.
Come on.
Behold, I will make them of the synagogue of Satan.
He said, I will make them of the synagogue of Satan. Who is he talking about?
Which they say.
Which say what?
Which say.
Which what they say?
Which say.
The Jewish people what?
Which say they are Jews.
They say they are what?
They say they are Jews.
Go ahead.
And are not.
But they are not. They're not Jews. Now, does that make the Bible anti-Semitic? Does it make the Bible it got to make the Bible anti-Semitic. Because according to y'all, if you say anything about these people, you anti-Semitic.
Right.
So therefore, according to the scriptures, we are Semitic. Give me 13 and 9. Revelation 13 and 9. Look, if y'all want to say that because we say that we're Jews is anti-Semitic, you're highly mistaken, and you got to get up out of that. Where you at?
Revelation chapter 13 and verse 9.
Read.
If any man.
If what?
If any man.
Come on.
Have an ear, let him hear.
So if any man, that means if anybody got an ear, let them hear. Read.
Verse 10.
Come on.
He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity.
He that led us into captivity must what?
Shall go into captivity.
He that led us into captivity must what?
Shall go into captivity.
Shall go into captivity. Read.
He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity.
Come on.
He that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword.
Come on.
Here is the patience and the faith of the saints.
That's where your faith lies in. That's where your patience lies in. It lies in waiting patiently for those that led us into captivity. Has to do what?
Has to go into, shall go into captivity.
Those that led these people on this sign into captivity shall go where?
shall go into captivity.
Shall go into captivity. It's just that simple.
Actually,
you reap what you sow. They sowed it. One day they got to reap it. And it's coming. Their reaping is coming fast. It's coming fast now.
So like you. What?
Now let me tell y'all something. Salakia, Kyrie Irving, you can look at both situations at this point. You can look at Kyrie and you can look at Ye. You can't say, Ye, Kanye West, we don't want to listen to him because he don't sound right. Because Kyrie Irving articulates it well. He apologized. But because he's not doing what they want him to do, they're telling him he got to do this in order to work.
So I'll give him a voice.
Now, I'm going to read it. This is what they're telling Kanye he got to do. Anybody got that list of what they told Kyrie Irving he had to do? They told him he had to do what? I think they told him he had to apologize. He got to say everything about the film is wrong. They want him to really humiliate himself and degrade himself and make it look like he don't know what he's talking about. But I'm telling you right now, he do. He's on to something. And each and every one of y'all that's coming by here, it's time for you to get in class. You have to get in class so that you won't fall in the same line as Kanye West and Kyrie. Now, before I go, I'm going to leave you with this. Give me Isaiah 14.
We have neither. Nobody ever came.
Now, it's very important to understand what he just read. The faith and the patience of the saints. Give me John 15 and 18. Now, this hate thing that's going on. I'm here to tell y'all that if y'all are hating us, or you are hating Kyrie or Ye for saying that, you just fulfilling scripture. That's all you are. Because in the book of John, chapter 15 and verse 18, this brother got to tell you something on how you fit this profile. You fit this prophecy. You fulfill it. Read.
John chapter 15 and verse 18.
Read.
If the world hates you.
If the what?
If the world hates you.
If the world hates you. Read.
Ye know that it hated me before it hated you.
So if you hate us because we're saying we the Israelites, you're supposed to hate us.
Right.
You're supposed to not like us. Read it again.
If the world hates you.
If the world hates you.
Ye know that it hated me before it hated you.
It hated Christ before it hated you. Read.
Verse 19. If ye were of the world.
If you what?
If ye were of the world.
Come on.
The world would love his own.
That's why y'all don't love us. That's why y'all don't love us. Because we not of this world. And you don't supposed to love us. Read.
But because ye are not of the world.
Read.
But I have chosen you out of the world.
When he choose us where?
I have chosen you out of the world.
Come on.
Therefore the world hateth you.
The world must hate you. If you're loved by the world, you cannot be walking in the truth. Read.
Verse 20. Remember the word that I said unto you.
So remember these words before I go. Read.
The servant is not greater than his Lord.
Come on.
If they had persecuted me.
If they had persecuted him. Go ahead.
If they had persecuted me, they will also persecute you.
They will also persecute you. Because, so if you don't like us, because we're saying that we're the Israelites, you fulfill the scripture. You're supposed to hate us. You're supposed to have a strong dislike towards black people that said that they are the Israelites. You only fulfilling scripture. Read it again. No, last verse 20.
If they have persecuted me.
If they have persecuted him. Read.
They will also persecute you.
They will persecute you. You got any more on that?
I'm concerned.
Go ahead.
If they have kept my saying, they will keep yours also.
See, we love to keep his saying. Now, that's my time. But we got free classes right down at 1232 North King Street. We are the Israelite School of Universal Practical Knowledge. We have been sent out by Commanding General Yohanna since 1969. We are the true Hebrew Israelites, blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans.
Nowadays I work hard on the job, still I come cross y'all. Still like I'm a criminal. Rhyme and get caught, it could be your first charge. Like, man, you ain't getting the minimum. It gon' dip, squat, 5 mile run. Push, pull, sit on, goddamn, get strong. Looking at my baby, trying to keep them doing wrong. It's too long before they grow, I can't leave them on their own. They killed Daddy like he had a 30-day cake. The news covering up the story, but they say it took me back to the time we lost Otis. To the knees crackers, they gon' tell you something bogus. And I'm thinking like, damn, what you tell the kids? You try to put up a fight, but did we fail the kids? Cause they ain't really got us looking like no damn good. And why success got to cost my manhood? They like women